Magistrate Douglas Ogoti has dismissed Itumbi's application to privately prosecute Matiang'i. The chief magistrate said that the court finds that the application failed to meet both legal and constitutional threshold that gives court authority to grant applicants green light to prosecute.
Recommending that the interested party must include officers from the Director of Criminal Investigation Land Fraud Department into the investigation in order to have a watertight case against the culprits to be charged. At paragraph 74 of the same affidavit, the applicant informed the court that by virtue of the constitutional mandate of the interested party, despite at paragraph 73 that the second respondent did not respond to issues raised in the letter, also informed the court that the interested party had no reasonable cause why it had not concluded the investigations to the loss of public funds.
I wish to say it's not over yet. I will be proceeding to the High Court for a revision of that ruling by the magistrate. I feel the magistrate applied himself unfairly, and that was the application that I filed yesterday. The application seeks for him to withdraw from the matter and the matter be allocated to someone else because of what I believe was inherent bias during his first hearing. He claimed that facts do not matter. We all know that affidavits, by their very definition, is statement of facts. There is absolutely no doubt from a ruling by the High Court that has been quoted by this magistrate that C.S. Matiang'i sought for a quality and standards report from his own ministry, which he ignored. Therefore, the issue that he was misled is moot.
Elsewhere, DCI both